was an interesting ending of last season.
Yeah. Disappointing for me. Disappointing. Right?
Did you feel disappointed?
As Stella, yes. I wish I had Julia's reaction, which was like, you know, she was like, this is for the greater good. And I have an immense amount of power that's like never depleted. I'll be okay. And then it's like as Stella is like, I waited 3 years for this moment. And I finally got it. And then it was like taken away.
Yeah. Exactly.
It's okay.
You can't even break out in a song after that.
It's just kind of like,
So how's she feeling at the beginning of the next season?
Well, we start out and our characters are not themselves. We actually had, I don't know if I'm even allowed to say it, but we have other actors playing our characters.
Oh.
It's crazy. So it's like, you'll see, you'll meet these characters that you thought you knew, but you don't know.
Wow.
So it's going to be interesting.
I hope that doesn't last for long, right?
Did you work with the actor playing you? Was that at all weird?
She was really cool. We could not be more different. Like, it's wild. I didn't realize that was what was going to happen. I thought we were going to play these completely other people, like, different people, but they literally are just playing us in scenes, you know? Wild.
So does that mean, what did that mean for pre-existing dynamics between your characters versus, like, are you playing new dynamics as actors and then also seeing old dynamics play out?
Gosh, not for Julia. I can't speak for the other actors. That might be true, but not in this particular character story.
What's
what
you tease about Julia? What?
Persona, the other you.
Well, she's an architect, and she's like a little bit clumsy, and she might not be a brunette. Not that there's anything wrong with that. But I would say, like, she just, you know, different.
How much do you know beyond this?
We're in episode 4 now, so there are going to be some pretty interesting, like, Julia gets a little bit of, like, a romantic life. I don't know how far it goes, but that's something to tease about. You may or may not know this suitor. He may or may not be a part of this cast.
Some people did enjoy the idea of Julia and other Penny. Is that something we may or may not see?
Previous seasons, like first season, is often compared to like an adult Harry Potter, and then we have like more of a Narnia feeling. Is there any magical or sci-fi parallel to this season so far that you can tell?
Like in what regards? Like
So like we have like the magic school with Harry Potter, and then we're off to Fillory in Narnia, and then I would say this past season we're dealing with a lot of like Lord of the Rings tropes as far as dealing with giant beasties and sort of things like that.
That's good. That's actually good. I've never thought of it like that, but that's really good. This season, what would you consider like the library? What would you consider that sort of like?
Oh.
There's some weird like power hierarchies within this season. I don't know how much that I can really talk about, and I don't know that much about it, but I just know that like library may have power. They got the power.
Okay.
And so there's no magic, right? So we're trying to get the power. But in regards to like a comparable comparison, I don't know. Like
is it Highlander Rose Magicians? There could be only one, we have power.
I'm waiting for like dead magicians.
Ooh.
Like, this is my I want to be Al. Oh, that's it, you know? I just want to be Al.
Have you pitched that? Did you pitch that? Did you tell the writers that's what you want?
This is the first time I'm saying that out loud. Okay. But that's me, and I'm going
to
do that today.
Yeah, I talked to Jade and Summer at the end of last season about a video I think you shot of them throughout. There was a movie being shot, but
Jade did that.
Throughout. Okay.
Did that.
When are we getting to see this magical video?
We saw it at the wrap party. You guys haven't seen it?
We have not. I don't think it's been released.
I should tell her to put it out.
Right?
Yeah, that's messed up. She put it out.
We'll call Jade. Get her on the
phone. She'd do it. She's cool. She'd like totally let it. Yeah. I don't think there's anything bad in it. We're all singing.
What are you singing?
Do you believe in magic? Aww.
Perfect.
So besides the characters trying to get their memories back, is there some sort of bigger storyline that takes us through the seasons? I mean, obviously, they're going to try to stop the library.
So I think that's what it is, basically, as far as I've been told and have read. at getting their identities back. Once they've secured their identities, getting magic back. Again.
One of my favorite dynamics in the show is Julia and Kate. So when they, you know, perhaps get their memories back or restore themselves, what would like to see that relationship being how much harder they
have? I hope that they wind up like on the same side of the street again and like just there for each other. I feel like they are. I feel like it's so not a catty friendship. It's so the trivial things can't compromise what they've written. You know what I mean? Like regardless of the way they've written it, I feel like what's behind it is a lot more deep. And I'd like to play in that. You know what I mean? But she, what was I gonna say? She, I haven't gotten to work with Jane Lawrence this year. Isn't that crazy? I think they're just trying to see people with other people, which is good, because now we have like, how many, 9 series regulars? So it's nice to get to see like different, I've still never shot a scene with Hale or Summer. It's like season 4, kind of crazy. But I got to work with Olivia a little bit last year, which was cool. So hopefully we get to see me with like a little bit more, maybe Elliot.
Do you have a favorite memory from set? Any of the seasons?
I can't think of like an all-time favorite. I'm sure it'll have to do something with Jason and making me laugh. You know, season 1, he convinced me that he was wearing a wig the whole time. And we're like shooting the last episode of the season, and I like went to touch, and he did this trick where he like moved his hair, like he like, you know, you can move your skin, and I was like, oh my god, it's a wig. And it wasn't. And that was kind of like, that was like earth shattering for me. I was like, whoa, everything I thought I knew, I didn't, and then I didn't. He's like a real good prankster.
How long did it take to get over that?
I'm still reeling.
Did you pay him back?
You know what, I haven't. But that's my goal this season. I'm like, okay, tactics on how to prank Jason better than he's pranked anyone. I haven't come up with a good plan yet, but I'm working. And I'm open to suggestions. If you guys have it.
So Julia's been God touched. She's a survivor. She's gone through so much trauma. Is there, like, I know when I'm talking to Summer, she was like, you know, sometimes I just whisper like little things into producers' ears. Like, maybe she could have like a happier turnaround or ending. Is there anything you really want for Julia?
The thing is that I feel like last year Julia's journey was acceptance, and I feel like she made it to the other side. And so like now she's just a part of the ride. Like of course she still is like a human with, like she's God, but doesn't possess the God-like powers. But she possesses still human emotions and like the natural things that we all like, just maybe on a different level. But I feel like the metaphor behind that is just acceptance. And it's like all of these things can happen to us, and they can be terrible, and they can be wonderful, and we can be, have things ripped away from us and taken from us, and then we can have things, gifts given to us. And it's like throughout it all, to be able to come full circle and like accept who you are and where you are at any given point in your life. And I feel like season 3 was that for her. So moving forward, it's kind of like she's a part of the tribe, she's a part of the ride, but she's like, she's just okay. There doesn't seem to be any like perpetual like dissatisfaction. Like for me as Stella, I'm dissatisfied because I want to be a goddess. But for her, she's just like okay. And it's nice to just kind of see her like be a part of the team and a part of the journey and try to find magic. But she's not on a quest for any like self-fulfilling prophecy. She's just sort of like, okay, I want to figure all this out. And how do I help? And like, what can we do? And like, it's nice.